When you look at saving taxes, Alan, we got to look at employees, because employees only have certain options, right? If I'm a small business owner, if I'm an investor, if I have assets, there's other strategies that you can potentially do. But if I'm an employee, I only got so much that I can work with.
Right. And so let's start with retirement plans. So IRA right off the bat. So there really wasn't a change there with the new tax law. It's still $5,500. And if you're over 50, 50 and older, it's $6,500. It actually goes up in 2019. So be aware of that. Simple IRAs, $12,500. If you're in a corporate plan that has a simple IRA, and if you're 50 and older, it's another $3,000.
401k plans. So if you look at your 401k plan, you might have to just defer 100% of your salary if you're trying to max it out. So just take a look to make sure, hey, how much have I put into the overall 401k? Because just know that you can put in about $18,500. And if you're over 50, there's a catch up. So close to $25,000 if you're over 50. So look at where you are. And a lot of times where people make mistakes, Al, is that you're over 50 and you didn't know that you could elect for the catch up. You thought it was automatic. So double check. You think you fully maxed out that plan, but you might not even be in the catch up provision within the overall 401k plan.
Well, that's exactly right, because as you say, you think you've done it, but you haven't really. And then, of course, if you're the business owner, you can put more than just that $18,500. You can put a lot more. It's actually up to $55,000 for a plan, depending upon your income level. And be aware, if you are self-employed, you can actually set up your own plan. It's called a solo 401k. You got to get that plan set up by December 31st, but you can fund that with an employee portion. In other words, your employee and employer both, so $18,500. Plus a profit sharing point amount. So it can be a pretty big amount, Joe.
So when you look at right now and the changes that happen within the overall tax code, I would say probably on the individual side, two huge change happen. The standard deduction is one. For single and married couples, it basically doubled. Because here's what the thought was, is that, all right, well, let's look and let's try to simplify things. And so if we have a standard deduction of 6,000 for married or a 6,000 some change, let's double that to 12. And so married couples, it was around 13,000. Let's double that just about to 24. So that increased the standard deduction. So you can either take the standard deduction or you can itemize. So you take whatever is higher. So they're saying, if I increase that overall standard deduction, then maybe most people will just take the standard and they don't have to worry about filling out the Schedule A. That actually hurt a lot of people here in California of how they changed the itemized deductions, Al. So I think a lot of people across the board might save a lot of tax, but in high tax states, it probably hurt them a little bit because of how they changed the itemized deductions.
Well, they did, and you probably have heard about this, is that if you're in a high tax state like California, New York, New Jersey, you might not be have done as well as you thought under this new tax law. And the reason is because, so state taxes and property taxes were now limited to $10,000. In other words, that's your total deduction. Even if your taxes are $50,000, whatever it may be, you can only deduct $10,000. So that's a really big change. And as a consequence, Joe, a lot of people are not going to be itemizing anymore.
Right. Is that, all right, well, here, I was paying $10,000 in property tax and another $30,000 in state tax. I can only do $10,000. All right, well, that was my biggest deduction. So now I'm just going to take the standard. Another thing, if I'm charitably inclined, they changed the rules there a little bit to kind of enhance it. It's now 60% versus 50. But there's a double-edged sword here because, right, if people are filing the standard deduction and they're not itemizing, they're not giving as much to charity because they potentially can't write it off on their tax return.
Well, that's true. And so let's just think about this logically. If you're using the standard deduction, then if you do a little bit more to charity at your end, you're getting zero tax benefit. So what a lot of people are doing is they're bunching their charitable deductions. Maybe they're taking 2 years and doing it all in 1 year so that they have enough deductions to be able to itemize. Or maybe they're setting up a donor advised fund, which you can actually put money into and they take the tax deduction the year you put the money in, but you can then dole it out as you see fit in future years.